another level in terms of their play. He enhances all teammates like no other player I've seen. LeBron's able to do that and get 30 points, which kind of makes you scared to help, so it's kind of like you're on an island with him. But overall, Kobe Bryant is the hardest I had to guard. Shannon, what does this tell you?
I don't think it's a big slight. We know what Kobe possesses. Kobe might be the second greatest offensive player that we've ever seen. Now, we exclude Will from all conversation because it's just not fair with the number of what he did. But when you think in modern, you know, outside of Will, you go Michael, you go Kobe, maybe James Harden, not what he's done over the last 3 years, Skip. So I get it. But it's just hard for me that, you know, I would look at the regular season, LeBron averages 28 points a game on 49% shooting. Kobe averaged 24 on 43% shooting. LeBron James in the finals against Iggy is 31, 11 and a half, and 8. I'm missing something, Skip. Iggy said the guy can still give you 30, get all of his teammates involved by assisting the basketball, and rebound it. But he says Kobe is a harder guard. Kobe is a volume shooter. And what Kobe's going to be able to do, Skip, when you put up that many shots, you're going to get a lot of shots. You're going to get some shots to go in, and they're going to look sensational in doing it. You know, Kobe's going to bump you and pump you and pump fake, fall away and hit a three-pointer. And people are like, oh, my God, he's going to come. He's more acrobatic in the air than LeBron is. LeBron is a locomotive. When you're coming downhill, hide the women and children because bad things about to happen. Kobe is seen as more elegant, more graceful, more Baryshnikov with a basketball. Yeah, he's ballet, you know, dancing, you know. Kobe can just, like, hang in the air and is so graceful. LeBron is like bull in China shop, wrecking stuff. That's what we do.
Okay.
For me, I don't look at it as a slight skill because when people ask me, people always ask me, Shannon, who's the toughest defender you ever went against? And when I tell them, they're like, who? The guy that gave me the toughest problem, Skip, to cover me, and the reason I got to the Hall of Fame was Albert Lewis. He was at Kansas City. He was an all-pro corner. And then they bumped him inside on the slot. And he was long. He was 6'2", about 190 pounds. He was long and rangy, and I never knew what I was going to get. Sometimes he would press me. Sometimes he would play off. Sometimes he would feather. But I never knew what I would get. But this is what I knew. I said, if I can consistently beat him, I can make it to the Pro Bowl, and the sky's the limit. So Every year, I go into the game, I got to beat that guy. And then nobody else would have a chance. So I get it for Iggy. Kobe is spectacular. I'm not arguing that. But LeBron shouldn't take this as a slight. Does, if I'm a defensive back, should Tom Brady take it as a slight if I say Peyton Manning is harder to prepare for? Or Drew Brees? No. He couldn't take it as a slight, you know, to each his own. But we know with 0-2-3 from Akron, we saw Iggy. You won finals MVP. Because you held a man to 36-13-9. That's what you got it. You got the finals MVP.
That's not why
he got it. That ain't why he got it.
No, sorry. Is it my turn?
It's your turn.
My man Andre Iguodala just stated the blatantly, painfully for you, obvious, because this is very obvious to me. It's as simple as this. In basketball terms, Kobe Bryant was a cold-blooded killer. He was second only in that regard to Michael Jordan. In basketball terms, LeBron's intangibles have never quite measured up to his tangibles. His mental toughness has never quite equaled his physical gifts and his extraordinary
talent. Well, how in the hell he got more game-winning shots than Kobe and Mike?
Yeah, well, that's just not true.
It is true!
Well, it's just... Everybody knows when the money is on the line, you want the ball in Kobe's, number one, Michael's hands, then Kobe's hands. You don't want the ball in LeBron's hands with the money on the line. And let's get back to why Iggy did win that MVP.
What did he do?
Your man, LeBron James, we just talked about legacy. He had the greatest legacy opportunity in his entire career back in the 2015 finals in game four in his house. Because he was pulling off extraordinary. What do I always tell you? The most impressed I ever was with your man LeBron James was in games 1, 2, and 3 of that finals, the first Golden State Cleveland finals. And again, he loses Kyrie at halftime. I mean, before
first
overtime.
Yep.
In game one, and he had already lost, obviously, Kevin Love. Mm-hmm. So now he's down his other two stars, and he puts that team literally on his broad shoulders and carries them through 1, 2, and 3 to a 2-1 lead with game 4 in the King's Palace in Cleveland. This is opportunity because if you close that deal that night, you're up 3-1. You're heading for Mount Rushmore, man, because you're about to upset the team that had the MVP, because that was Steph's first MVP year. Klay made the All-Star team that year, and Draymond was first team All-Defense. Okay? So you're about to upset that team. That is legacy achievement. That is the one where I sit back and say, wow, LeBron, that was greatness, because that was hard. And remember, he was just, the usage rate was off the charts because he just dribbled the ball off the floor and shot the ball every time, and Golden State could not deal with him. And what happened in game 4? A strategic move was made by one Steve Kerr. What was that? You know what? I saw something from Iggy in game 3. I think I might just start him tonight. I'm going to insert him into our starting lineup. And what happened? LeBron came up smaller than little Richie Paul that night, right? He did. He came up smaller than little Richie's not a big guy, you know? And LeBron goes 7 of 22 that night. He goes 1 for 4 from 3. He goes 5 of 10 from the free throw line. This is the money game, man. You've got it, and you lose it by 21. You lose 103 to 82 at home. And all of a sudden, it's 2-2. And then it's 3-2 Golden State, and then it's 4-2 Golden State, and it's game over. So you had the opportunity, but who shut you down in that game? Not for the big picture, but in that game, Andre Iguodala did a number on you. And by the way, while you scored 21 points that night, he scored 22, and he made 4 of 9 threes, and he took the game over on both ends.
Yeah, he contributed, but Skip, but if you look at it, the regular season and postseason, Kobe averages 24 points, 6 rebounds, 4.5 assists, shooting 43%. LeBron is 29, 7 rebounds, and he doubles the assist total while shooting 49%. I just believe that when you look at, and Kobe is a more of a nice one-on-one player. That's not what, and Iggy made that abundantly clear. LeBron is a guy that tries to get others involved, helps them play at a higher level than what they're accustomed to playing at, but he still can give you 30. When have we ever said that about Kobe making somebody better? Kobe makes himself better. I got no problem with that. Kobe is as good in the one-on-one set as that you'll see.
But we're just talking about harder to guard. Period, end of story,
I just think a great big man is harder to guard than a great little man. That's general rule of thumb for me.
Okay, unless you're also 7 feet tall and you're good on defense, then you can guard him.
Ain't nobody guarding, we've never seen a package like that.
Like who?
Like LeBron.
Oh, I thought you meant like
body like mailman.
Yeah.
The ability to see over the court like magic.
Yeah, but in Wilt's day, there was not another Wilt on defense,
And that's why I said you have to take it like one-on-one. You got to take Wilt out of the equation because he has 150, 50-point games, so we can't do anything about that.
Okay.
All these 60-point games. But, look, I'm not here to skip. Iggy's guarded both. I'm not here to tell him who he should think is tougher. I'm just saying the numbers. But what you feel is what you feel. You know, look, I went against some great guys. I played against Rod Woodson and Mark Carrier and some guys that's in the Hall of Fame at the same, Ronnie Lott. But the guy that gave me the most problems was Albert Lewis. So don't tell me, well, Shannon, this guy's in the Hall. I get that. I'm not saying that he's not great. I'm just saying the guy that caused me the most problem. So I'm not here to, Iggy, you say Kobe. Okay, Kobe it is. But I'm taking number 2. I'm taking number 6.
So Shannon Sharp just put him in the same conversation.
With
Kobe and LeBron. Shannon.
No, I didn't. See,
LeBron
there you go.
And Shannon.
I just see that.
Shannon and Albert Lewis. Okay.
Why you always do that? I'm just trying to find an analogy of saying there have been great players that I've played against, but someone that people might not think is the one that caused me the most problems.
Okay. Now we got to finish this off by what happened at the end of game 3 in LeBron's house in 2018. It was the second game 3 against Kevin Durant in the Golden State Warriors. And with a lot of time left, really with about 12 seconds left.
No, that was the first game 3.
Wasn't it the second one? I thought it was 2018.
No, that's when they had the big lead and they can't let them come back.
Was it? Whichever one. It was the end of the game.
Yeah, I was at that game.
I looked this up.
I was at the game.
Okay.
That was when we was in Cleveland.
2017.
Yeah, okay. we were in Cleveland.
Okay. All right. Yeah, we were there.
Yeah, we were there. Yeah.
Okay, so it's the end of game three, the first game three against Kevin Durant.
Yes.
Ball's inbound. It's a three-point game, and LeBron's got a three-point shot to tie it. And not only does Iggy knock the ball out of his hands, but he knocks it off LeBron out of bounds and makes LeBron just look pretty silly.
But here's the thing, Skip, if you remember, Iggy did the same thing to who? Dame Lillard. Remember?
Okay. Well, I know that was later, but this was the first time I saw it.
Yeah, but here's but the thing is, he knows there's only like 2 or 3 seconds.
Okay.
So he knows LeBron has to catch the ball.
It's not 2 or 3, it's 12, because he shot with 10.
Yeah, but okay? I'm saying, but so, he knows he got to get a shot up just in case he misses.
LeBron, the offensive genius that he is, why wouldn't he pump fake on that?
Oh, my goodness.
Why wouldn't he pump fake? No, seriously. What if he had pump faked? Could he have gotten a three-point foul? Oh, Lord have mercy of him shooting 3 free throws to tie.
But here's the thing, Skip. Iggy didn't leave his feet. Mm. So even if he had pump fake, Iggy's not there. Mm. It's not like Iggy jumped. Mm. Iggy knows, I don't care how great you are, Skip, you got to bring the ball to a shooting position. Mm. So the ball's going to start here from the beginning. Mm. Iggy knows that. So on the process of bringing the ball up, Iggy gets his hands in. The ball flies up. LeBron tries to get it. It caroms off his foot.
Oh.
Okay, give Iggy credit. That was great.
I bet Kobe gets that shot off. That's just me. I just bet he gets it off.
Who knows? Kobe might have been moping and not even taking a shot.
Excellent.
You remember how he did
discussion,
that?
Gentlemen.